Cheers!
Welcome to Movie Bitches!
RuPaul's Drag Race Season 11 Finale!
Oh! Just wasn't, I was waiting for episode.
Episode 14, the grand finale! Thank you everyone for coming along this season with us. It's been, God, you know, Monet Exchange came out as the winner of All Stars 4 and Miss Congeniality from season 10,
and I was like,
all within a year. And I was like, you guys, really, this is too much.
It's too much.
That's insane.
Yeah.
They've had two seasons, like, it's insane.
Yeah.
But anyway.
But we made it to the end.
Yes.
We're here.
We're here. We appreciate you guys supporting us. Thank you to our Patreon supporters. $5 a month or more gets you early access, including early access to the remainder of All Stars 4. Make sure to subscribe, thumbs up, definitely subscribe because we'll have a bunch of new fun, exciting things coming.
Gosh, very exciting.
Yeah. Happy Pride.
Yes.
Well, so someone asked that we wear our outfits from the reunion.
Oh, right.
Which I thought would have been fun, but instead we decided to honor Team Evie and Team Brooklyn by wearing these fabulous shirts that Rick designed that you can buy at Redbubble. So go get them.
We thought, you know, it's going to be a lip sync smackdown for the crown, so we should, you know, honor still the best lip sync of the whole season.
Yes.
Including this episode. Yes.
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 Yes. But also, these were the final two, so...
Yeah, like, it made sense,
So you might have noticed that we were in the finale, you know.
Yes, we got the inside track, we got to be there in person.
Which was really fun, it was
so
very
fun.
Long, but really fun.
What was it, 6 hours?
Mm-hmm.
6 hours all told.
I think...
Seven?
Maybe from like when we got there.
But no, it was so fun and seeing all the kind of behind the scenes stuff. I mean, there wasn't that much that they cut out, really.
No, I mean, mostly it was like, oh, they had us do audience reaction stuff that they then put under those really weird videos.
Oh, we'll talk about the really weird videos.
It's simply my time.
I forgot about these videos.
I did too.
I forgot about these videos.
So we were sworn to secrecy.
Sworn to secrecy. We went to the taping.
We're no Giselle.
We're no Giselle _ Instagram. What was it?
I don't know.
So yeah, you couldn't have your phone out. They had people watching. And in the middle of taping, we hear on the loudspeaker, you know, we see you posting on Reddit. We see you posting on Instagram, Giselle _ blah, blah, whatever. We're going to find you. We're looking at the angles that the pictures were taken and we're going to track you down. And they were like, checked everyone's phone. I mean, not our, like,
no. Yeah.
They got to the section, were checking people's phones, and then they kicked her out. It was crazy.
It was
like a
crazy
witch hunt.
It really was.
Vanjie, everyone's like,
yeah,
get her! Where is she? You know, I was like,
get out!
And then I kept being like, oh, I didn't, no, I mean, of course, no, I didn't take a picture. But like, I was like, oh, God, we're God.
Am I Giselle? No, I'm not Giselle.
Turns out, no. But yeah, so we couldn't say anything.
Well, I wouldn't want to anyway.
Oh, I wouldn't want to spoil it anyway. But it was weird, like, knowing what happened and then talking to people and having to remember that not everyone knew what happened.
Yes. Well, particularly with these finales now with the lip sync offs.
Right.
Where like in the older days, it was like, well, that's the final four. You know, like no one really knows what happened because they filmed all the endings.
Yeah.
Like who could say? But now it's like, well, we know for sure that Silky and Akiria do not win.
Yes, exactly.
They don't.
But anyway, we'll sprinkle little tidbits about stuff that happened during the finale as we go. But the finale starts, and all the eliminated queens come out one by one. Soju comes out first, of course, because she got eliminated first. And I really liked that. I thought her wig was really beautiful and intricate. All these, you know, stick pins coming out of it, and this red, deep red dress.
Yeah.
And I kind of liked the, like, weird, like, built-in boobs. I don't know. I wasn't, like,
I didn't
somehow
mind it.
It was like obvious, you know, it's obviously not boobs because it was just like, you know, a built-in cup into the corset.
Yes.
You know what I mean? But somehow I was like into it. I don't know. It looked kind of interesting to me.
I didn't mind it.
It's like red peplum. I thought she looked beautiful.
It was simple, but elegant and lovely. And I thought that was nice. And then next was Kahana Montrese.
I'm sorry, who was it?
Kahana? Kahana.
Moana.
No, but yeah, so Kahana's was interesting.
Sure.
She had this weird
looked like
neck
a
piece.
Denim Ed Hardy Victoria's Secret Angel. you know,
sure,
a lot going on.
With like a little bit of like Mardi Gras, like Carnivale and like Venice going on.
Sure. Patchworky wings. I mean, it was big and bold. I didn't like the shorts. Somehow having it be shorts made it more daytime. Wasn't in love with it.
And then like April?
Well, you really dress up the shorts.
I did dress up my shorts.
You have the right length, the right, you know, whatever. I don't know, somehow with like the big fabulous wings, and then it was like bike shorts. Almost.
Sure.
You know what I mean? Just was like, wasn't as like, ooh, yes. Wasn't a complete look. It was dramatic, but it wasn't like a yes, head to toe, yes, this is, I know what you're doing.
Agreed.
And then Honey Davenport comes down in another beehive look. You know, I like this one better than the reunion.
Yes.
Sort of simpler.
Yeah. Well, and I love this one with this headpiece with the little bees. There were jewels, like, but they look like bees.
Little bees on these wire, you know, it makes it her big, you know, collar of bees. And she's the queen of the bees, you know, and that kind of thing.
It was fun. It was. And it's like leather.
Yeah, this like
skirt.
Leather ball gown. Yeah. And the sort of hexagonal honeycomb bodice.
Yeah, bodice.
Like, it was like really very good, but I was like, oh, it's more bees.
Yes.
I'm just ready to branch out.
Absolutely. Particularly, like when we saw this live.
Right.
We hadn't seen the reunion yet.
Yes.
And so it was like, oh, I get it. She's
like,
Honey Davenport coming back for the finale.
In, like when she came into the workroom, it was like a honey, and this was like an elevated, like, oh,
I got it. But then it was like also with the reunion, which we just watched last week,
it was a little much.
Next was Mercedes and Mon Diamond. I don't know why I said Mercedes weird, but I did.
I kind of like it.
Mercedes.
I kind of like it.
Mercedes.
She looked beautiful. It was sort of this orangey, red, tomato soupy, kind of just like really beautiful pageant-y kind of, you know, gown. I like that it had this sort of big open side slit that had like this caged sort of volume of over the hip, and that really kind of made it a little more dramatic. Didn't like that you could see her underwear. You know, it was like, it was like gold, but like you could tell, you could see
it was still,
like the upper part of the underwear. It was like, oh, that kind of ruins the like illusion of this like full leg.
Sure,
you know? But
sure.
She looked really pretty and nice. Yeah. It was like beautiful.
It was lovely.
So the next out is Ariel Versace.
Oh, I'm sorry, who?
Ariel Versace? Not sure. She had some good reaction shots throughout the episode.
Yes, she did.
What? Yeah. She had it all going on.
Yeah, except fun. We also had a good reaction shot. I think maybe our first.
Yes.
What from the far side was of us reacting to her. I'm pretty sure it was me reacting to her outfit where I was just like, I don't like this. Oh, Scarlett.
Yeah, I'm like, I don't know, but I mean, this was like perfectly cute bubblegum princess, you know, explosion of tulle.
Perfectly Ariel.
Yeah.
Ariel, whatever.
When we were there in person, you couldn't see as many of the details, and it really did look like she was just wearing a, like, tulle that she had, like, cinched at the waist. It was harder to tell.
It was like a pink tutu wedding gown, but, like, ugly.
I think that would be ugly regardless. You know, on TV, you could see all the details and how it was actually really structured and kind of like, oh, that was like, oh, that's cute. You know, oh, you look cute. But like from where we were sitting far away, it just looked like a tutu explosion. So that was our faces.
Yes.
Look, Scarlett's coming out in this red.
This red
Ooh,
number.
Scarlett looked great in this.
She looked beautiful.
Mermaid, the dramatic mermaid gown.
Yeah.
Like a red. Jeweled head to toe with these like pointed, you know, boob wings and just like, yes.
Yeah.
Really good.
Really good. You know, we saw her at Sasha Velour's and she looked beautiful. And then
she was snatched.
She was snatched at Sasha Velour's.
Snatched.
And then we saw her at DragCon and she looked beautiful.
Looked beautiful. She's really nice.
Yeah.
I don't know what everyone's talking about.
That reunion, man, I don't know.
Weird.
Yeah.
Next out is Raja O'Hara in this like purple navy, you know, fantasy. I liked the whole color palette.
Sure.
I thought I got
purple is her color, we decided.
Purple is her color, we'd say. I thought I got crapped up with all the accessories, like she had big earrings with then the long hair and then the neckline and then gloves and a big old bracelet. It was just like, oh, you know, like this could have been really simple and chic.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and just like clean lines. And even if she'd worn, you know, I think if she'd worn her reunion wig, that finger waved, Because yeah. I liked this wig, this sort of thin, crimped, you know, purple hair. But it just didn't quite go with the dress, like this, like, classic navy.
Almost if she just swapped them, I think.
Yeah, and, like, it had these, you know, peekaboo stripes throughout it. So the dress and the body were, like, on point for me. But it just looked a little crapped up.
It was, yeah, I thought it was kind of simple.
Well, maybe that's why she tries to jazz it up with so many accessories.
Maybe. So then next was Plastique Tiara. And she came out and everyone in the audience was gagged.
I mean...
This was spectacular.
Just such an entrance, such a look, this angelic Vietnamese, I don't know, maybe wedding gown. I mean, it looked like it, I don't know.
Sure.
And these sleeves and the
jewels and the
crown
and more jewels.
Peacock feather apparatus behind her. And we were all like, because we started to see like where the girls were going to sit.
Oh, yeah.
And I was like, how's she going to sit down? This is crazy.
Yeah.
And like, basically, they got down and she had to take this whole harness off with the feathers and like some PA, like, took it away or whatever so she could sit down. It was funny.
It was silly.
But this was, I mean, this was beautiful.
It was. It was gorgeous. Stunning.
So then another gag, Suga walks out and is holding these
red roses.
These red roses across, I'm walking down and what is this? And thwomp and like throws the roses down to reveal this big, you know, Madonna, you know, Virgin Mary, like jewel encrusted, you know, poncho-y thing. You're like, what? Everyone was like, oh my God, we're losing our minds, yes!
She looked like one of the candles that you light, yeah.
Yeah!
That Valentina, remember when she...
Yes, it was very Romeo plus Juliet.
Oh my God, know? Yes, it was.
Very that. And everyone's like, yes, oh my God, oh my God. And then to pull off and reveal another like, burgundy velvet, you know, just like really simple and chic gown. I mean, it fit really well.
It did. I didn't love the color, maybe. There was something about it, I was like, oh, I kind of like the first one better.
I mean, the first one was more graphically like,
sure.
Whoa, and then this like sun crown was really cool, and it was like, yes!
That was beautiful. Then next is Miss Nina West.
Oh my God.
In this, it was like pinky red.
Yeah, red.
With these tabs sticking out, and at first she's walking, you're kind of like, what's this?
Oh, I was like, oh, it's paper doll tabs.
Oh, I guess you already knew.
I played with a lot of paper dolls.
Love it.
I don't know why I'm not a child from 1914, but I played with a lot of paper dolls. Get to use your scissor skills, get in there, dress her up, put this on. I think I had like paper dolls of like Little Women. Like it was like Joe and Beth and Amy and you know. And I'll try on this hoop skirt.
Oh,
and this is when Joe cut off all her hair to pay for Christmas presents, you know, like that kind of thing.
Good.
It's a fun time. But anyway, yeah. This, I mean, Nina.
Good.
Literary nerd. But yes. Nina is like, I mean, it fit perfectly. And the little, like, cheeky wink of these tabs.
Yep,
and then when she turns around, this nude illusion, and it's like jewel encrusted butt cheeks, and like the patterned paper with the scissors and the dots and the. I mean, it was just like really, really good.
This was kind of Manila. Esque, where it's like, oh, I'm going to take this idea of a thing and turn it into a fashion dress. And
exactly.
It's like, yeah, that's fine. The only thing that we didn't really care for the wig with the dress.
I just like the color combo. I thought, like, you know, the wig looked beautiful and polished, but somehow that pink with the red, I don't really think I like pink and red together.
Sure, I get
personally.
That. I get that.
So I was just like, not my favorite. And then when Nina came out, I mean, she got the full standing ovation, cheering, like people were like losing their minds, like, oh my God, Nina!
For like a good minute.
Like a while. That's probably why it lasted so long. Like the show taped for so long. So many
we did it to
standing
ourselves.
O's and, you know, like chanting for three specific people. but yeah, I mean, everyone just lost it. And they like, she was out there for a while and Nina was so just like, really? Oh my God. Like, I can't, like, she was so just like, I can't believe it. Next out, Miss Vanjie. Oh my God. In this cheetah catsuit just snatched for the gods. Oh my God. She looked so good in person. And it was like, really, really sparkling in the light in person. It didn't show up as much on camera, but just, I mean, she looked like a disco ball, a cheetah catsuit disco ball. I mean, oh my God. I mean,
she looked so amazing.
And these gold, like, even cheetah sequined, like, belts and harnesses and all this stuff. I'm like, yeah. And the shoes, it was like all one thing. It just, like, was all one thing.
This was gorgeous. I loved her little short wig.
It's fucking great. She always have a fan.
Oh my God.
She should always have a fan. She was working that fan the whole night.
Yes.
So good.
She was the most fun of the finale.
I would say her and Evie.
Yes.
I had a lot of fun with Evie.
I did too.
Well, and then the second standing O of the night, everyone stood and cheered for Vanjie just as long.
If not longer.
Vanjie! Oh my God!
And then they did it again later when she came back on stage. It was like, hold on, I want to be on the wheel, Rue.
Before the whole show started, Michelle came out and was like, okay, we're taping this before the final episode airs, so I have to spoil you guys, and we know that it sucks, but like, here you go. Last week, Miss Vanessa Vanjie went home. People were like, riotous. People were so upset that Vanjie was gone, and Michelle was like, okay, let her hear it, like, so she can hear you from the wings, and I was like, Vanjie! So everyone just like lost it. Then the big doors to Oz open. I mean, it looked like, you know.
Yeah.
Don't look behind the curtain, you know. And then Rue came out in like a bright green emerald.
Yeah, that's true.
She looked like she was from Emerald City, kind of.
Well, it was more like Green Screen City, but yeah.
Well, yeah, she came out in this green dress. I'll say this, it looked better on camera.
Yes, it did.
In person, it was like, ugh, what is this color? No.
I told her not to wear green. I hate it.
It still isn't my favorite color.
No.
In the color wheel. But yeah, it did look like, are they planning on green screening Rue into this finale? What's happened?
I would love to see someone green screen silly things on top of Rue.
Ooh, I like that. It's Miss Vanjie's face.
Who was that? Mercedes had a green fringe on the runway?
Yeah, it was the same
color.
Yes.
And someone did that.
Yeah.
So now they can do it on Rue.
Okay, somebody take our reaction of us laughing gif and put it on Rue's dress.
I like that. It could be Rue saying, I always laugh when I say that, and then Vanessa's like, 69!
I'd love that.
Yeah,
that'd be fun. But yeah, I mean, you know, Rue looked very Rue and,
It
was beautiful.
She's super fun.
She always looks beautiful.
That's true.
You know, but it was not my favorite color.
No.
But do I love RuPaul. I mean, not that it's a surprise, but like being in the presence of greatness, you're just like, wow, oh my God, wow.
When Rue, I think, when like Rue's up there having fun, you're just like, I just want more of this. Like, I want to hang out with you and be silly.
Yeah, like she's quick, she's funny, she doesn't give a shit, she's just like having a good time, really brings the room up. I mean,
she knows how to work a crowd.
We were there for 6 hours and I wasn't mad about it.
No,
I was
really.
Like, I could use some food and I'm kind of tired, but I wasn't like, oh, get this over with. You know what I mean? I was just like, yes, RuPaul.
Yeah.
She's fucking great.
Great.
Love her. And this is when we get your first close-up.
Yeah. Oh, we didn't talk about this. Did we talk about it with Sarge?
Oh my God. I mean, I like didn't want to take my phone out at all because I didn't
want to get yelled at
or whatever, and I didn't want to spoil anything.
No.
I didn't want to
But
I wanted to be like, look at Sarge. Oh my God. But yeah, he did shove a camera in our face, and I was like, it's Sarge!
So quick commercial break, and we will be back with, a whole lot more.
Oh, so there's so much more?
Yeah. Oh boy, and so then, these videos. We did not have to sit through these live.
No, because they were like, well, we don't have them edited.
Ready, or
something. Cut to the video, you know, and everyone had to be like, pretending like they were watching something. This video! Was so weird. I mean, they were all weird.
Yeah.
I guess Evie's worked because she's weird.
Yes.
But yeah, this video that's like some kind of behind the music parody, docudrama. I don't even know. These like black and white shots that look really 90s, and then these crossfades and crossfades and crossfades.
And here I am on the street.
B-roll that has no context for anything. It was just like, well, we need some footage.
Yep.
You know, it was like, walk down the street, do this, or whatever. And then Akira's like, serial killer wall? Remember her? Like,
oh yeah, she has like,
what's this?
It was like a serial killer / detective wall. It was like, what's she solving?
Yeah,
what murder?
Ooh.
What episode of SVU is this?
She's solving the mystery of Ariel's wig.
Oh my God, right? Now that would have been great.
Right, get to the bottom of it. Because then she's walking down the street and Fortune Feimster's there and she starts choking on a hot dog and then she gives her Heimlich twerk. Or was that twerk? twerking Heimlich maneuver.
Yeah.
It just wasn't very funny either.
No, not really.
It was like, oh, well, that was weird. I mean, the only thing I liked about her video was she's got this, like, kind of sorceress outfit on, and there's smoke, and there's crossfades, and it's sort of like, ooh, I'm doing magic.
Sure.
And then, like, that awkward shot of her just, the crown is in the foreground, and her just sort of going, like, something about it was, like, awkward and funny to me, and I was like, oh, well, that was silly, but,
sure.
Like, mostly it was nonsense.
Yes.
She comes out, we haven't talked about her look.
No.
She was, like, her own nest of feathers.
Yeah.
Right? It's just, like, surrounding her. I mean, at the show, and watching the show, I had the exact same reaction where I was like, oh, yeah. Oh, it's pants.
Yes.
It's like, oh, look at this slinky bird serpentine. Oh, it's pants. Oh, no. Where you have like a train of feathers. But
I guess,
like,
that's true. Why pants?
It just seemed like it should all be connected.
Sure.
It threw me off.
Sure.
I was like, oh, it kind of looked like one of those optical illusions, like she was sitting, but she wasn't. You know those Halloween costumes where you've got, like, the baby on your back?
Yeah.
But it looks like you're the baby or whatever. What are those things? You know what I'm talking about?
Right? Yes, where it's like, it's, oh, like a, my head's here.
It's like an optical
baby
illusion. Yeah. It kind of looked like that. It constantly looked, she was like, and am I sitting? I might be sitting. A little bit.
A little bit.
But just the green and the feathers and the opulence and this, like, cap, this, like, feathered cap,
yeah,
glittering,
yeah,
feathers. I mean, she looked gorgeous.
She did.
Something about the proportion just wasn't perfection to me because of the pant and then the nest and then the bat. But, like, it was really cool still. I don't know.
You wanted it to be a gowned.
It was only a gown.
Mm.
I needed to be a gowned.
Gotcha. Uh-huh.
Was it with down? Her mom and her granny were there. And RuPaul's like, oh, looks like glamour runs in the family. And then her mom, like, shaking her ass to the camera. And then, of course, they cut to you being like.
Yeah, right. Oh, yeah.
We couldn't see any of it. We could hear.
Yeah.
Couldn't see a thing.
No.
But it seemed like you were really pleased with her ass.
I mean, get it, girl.
The diamond.
Yeah, that diamond crown.
The diamond crown. Yes.
So they had the 50 years of Stonewall. They had a nice little video about Pride and Stonewall and remembering the
anniversary.
Yeah.
It was like a silly kind of montage. Not silly. I don't mean to say silly, but, like, there was just obvious, like, documentary tricks in there of we didn't have enough footage.
Sure.
Is what I'd say. So there's, like, weird B-roll. And it'd be like, sexual orientation, discrimination, check yes. Or
no.
I say no. And I was like, what is this? What's happening? We're voting on this? What's going on? It was like, you know, Googling, you know,
yes,
like science. Or, like, it was just like Googling something random and being like, blurp. You know, it was like, no.
Yeah. Yes? No.
I'm against it.
Whatever it is, I'm against it.
And I was like, yeah, of course. You know, it was just like kind of silly. But it was like a nice little mini retrospective. Of,
yeah.
Like, remember this? And, like, yes, we should. And we should celebrate it. It's the month of Pride. And, like, yes. So that was nice.
People died. Nobody died?
No one died? Right.
Like, when people don't know what Stonewall is.
Won't you tell everybody what that is?
That was fighting for gay rights. Mm-hmm. And people were killed.
Nobody was killed at Stonewall.
I have to play Alaska's new, she's a new song called Pride,
uh-huh,
where she makes fun of that.
Oh, I love it.
It's fun.
Oh, no one died at Stonewall? Stunning.
Next is Brooklyn Heights, and they play her whole video.
That was weird and awkward.
Yep.
More black and white. But it was like, it's like they're in the real world, you know? Things are about to get real.
Well, she, like, had this, like, buttoned up flannel.
It was
real
very,
all the way.
She, like, Taryn Killam and Matthew Lillard,
yeah,
in the 90s or something.
Yeah.
I was like, what's going on here exactly? You know? And then again, they're on the street. I mean, the only thing I kind of liked of hers was her, like, in drag, trying to be on that bird scooter, just being like, I don't like this.
Right, yeah.
No, I don't like it.
I don't like it.
Tiffany Pollard is her guest.
Right.
And they have a whole thing that wasn't
New
fun.
York, Brooklyn, New York. I was like, I don't care. It's not funny. To me. But then she comes out and looks gorgeous.
Oh my god, this, like, frostbitten queen.
The queen of the north.
The queen of the north with this, like, almost ice dancing gown.
Yeah.
You know, with, like, the nude illusions,
yeah,
and all these sort of crystalline, you,
yes,
know.
Yes, she would have fit in perfectly into the Sonja Henie biopic.
Oh, yes. I thought you were going to say into Narnia.
That too.
She seemed like she could go to Narnia.
Oh, you know what would have been fun?
Huh.
It wouldn't have really made sense, but if there was, like, a weird ice skating dance break in Narnia.
I mean, I'm always here for a weird ice skating dance break, so.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Matilda, but she can't ice skate.
I mean, maybe
she'll make them do it to perform for her.
Yes.
And then we just see this like 5 minute ice skating dance break.
I love it. But no, and then the matching headdress with the dripping jewels, you know, here and there. So when she moved, it just, you know, gave it a little sparkle and shimmer and movement. It was like, yes, bitch. Yeah. This was good.
Yeah. It was beautiful. Gorgeous.
Well, and then Brooke is getting interviewed. They're talking to her and blah, blah, blah. And then of course they cut to Vanjie.
Oh yeah.
Like, and they weren't even talking about Brandy or anything. It's cut to Vanjie and she's like,
what? Wait,
get out of here. Well, and then they sort of transitioned into the Opalette. Because it was like the remix.
Yes.
Opalette.
I don't remember how it goes.
Cara Delevingne is like, dancing. Opalette. And then like Akira's mom is just like, sitting like not.
Oh, giving, they're just sitting there like, what's happening?
Giving any fucks and just being like, what?
I don't know.
Well, later someone pointed out that she like fell asleep. I was like, ah! She was in that.
It was a long night.
It was a long night. I got sleepy, but it was just funny that like she's sitting behind Cara Delevingne like in this giant drag show. You know, just like I'm gonna take a nap.
Yeah, and then they do another video this time in memoriam.
For
Michelle's breasts.
Her big old bitties.
Yeah, tig old bitties.
Tig old bitties.
We're gonna miss celebrating those two tig old bitties, girl. Take a look.
They make a couple of jokes about it, and she's like, of course, we have to make, you know.
Yeah. Is there anything you want to get off your chest?
Rim shot. And then this like montage was funny. This made me laugh.
Yeah,
I'm
yeah.
just like, those are breasts.
These
are breasts.
These are breasts.
Oh, girl.
These are breasts. I don't want to see boobs when I'm at Drag Race.
I love Julianne Lewis. But I don't come to Drag Race to look at boobs. What am I doing trying to look at boobs at Drag Race? I was like, yeah, I love it.
So then Silky's video, also same weird nonsense. I mean, it was like, you know.
More black and white, cross fading, you know.
A lot of words.
Yeah.
It was all a lot of words that I was like, I don't really know what they're saying.
Right.
Does it like, really
why
matter?
I should win. I guess it was like, why I should win, kind of.
I guess. I was honestly just like, you know, we could have done with either none or a lot less of this. And a lot more of like seeing the legendary queens or whatever they call them, the drag legends.
Yeah.
It was like 2 seconds of Raja. And you know what? She needed a lot more. I'll tell you that. We'll get there.
We'll get there.
But yeah, so Silky's video, you know.
Well, the only thing I did like about this is it seemed like Silky was sort of like owning her imperfections.
Yeah.
And by owning her imperfections, admitting that she had imperfections, you know what I mean? Which was refreshing.
I own exactly who I am. Even the many imperfections.
And T.S. Madison and her have tea.
Yeah.
Everyone had a little guest.
Celebrity guest.
Or whatever.
Yeah.
Silky comes out in this, I mean, I don't know what to think about this. She comes out in this Tracy Turnblatt, like, roach dress. And I'm like, okay, A, Alaska already did that.
At a finale.
Well, I was at the reunion. You know, that's strike one. Like, Alaska already did it. But then also, it just, there wasn't anything different about it.
Right.
It like, from what Alaska had already done, which was a specific reference to something from, you know what I mean? So I was just kind of like, well, I guess she was referencing Hairspray, but really she was referencing her fly that Michelle called a roach.
Right. So she was like, oh, you called me a roach, so now I'm going to wear a cockroach dress, but just kidding, I'm going to peel this off and reveal not a cockroach dress, nothing related to it at all.
Yeah.
I think if Alaska hadn't done it, I would have been like fully on board for it.
Right.
Because then it's like, yes, I see what you did there. Yes,
right.
They called you a cockroach, but now you're wearing the cockroach and it's Hairspray and you're a girl and it's great.
Right.
But because it was literally something that we've seen on the show already.
Right.
In exactly basically the same manner, I was like, but now the reference is played out.
Yeah, maybe, you know what would have been fun? If it was like the exact dress, except the cockroaches were giant flies.
I mean, that would be really
right?
funny.
And she's like, I'm a fucking fly, bitch.
Exactly. Yeah.
And I'm fly.
Yeah, oh, you thought it was cockroaches? It's flies.
Like, that at least would have been sort of a little twist.
Sure, sure.
The same idea. But her reveals are always underwhelming because she doesn't seem to have a lot of tude with them.
That's the biggest thing about a reveal is you gotta sell the reveal as a moment, mm-hmm. and you have to make it into a performance.
Yes.
And if it's not, then you're just peeling clothes off.
Yeah. So that's how I often feel with her reveals.
A lot of reveals, not just her.
Not just hers, but like...
But yes.
All of
her. All of hers.
Pretty much all of hers. Yes. I'm like, oh, well, that was underwhelming. I mean, except for Bitch, I Was Ready. Because it was such a performance.
Because that was a performance, yes.
I was motherfucking ready! I was ready to do so!
What does that have to do with anything, bitch?
And then ruin her, like, kind of like walk...
Oh, yeah.
Walk away through the doors, and then Christine and the Queens comes out.
Yeah.
One eyelash. Maybe it was like a Clockwork Orange thing?
Maybe.
But she was fab.
She was. I didn't know who she was.
I don't know who that is, but she had a great voice. And she had a fun outfit, and she had a lot of energy, and I was like, yes, bitch, work.
Yeah, she's apparently French. I guess she's just had a new song come out with, I want to say Charlie XCX or someone.
Oh, cool. She comes out and starts singing, and then it's like, okay, what do they call the past?
Drag legends.
The drag legends of the past. Legends of the hidden drag queens. Now that I would watch.
Oh my God.
It was like drag trivia. And then, like, when you went into the bad room and, like, the Aztec, like, guard used to come out and grab you, but, like, it's, you know, Yara Sophia or something.
And it's all hip pads instead of, like, those big foam blocks.
And, like, breastplates. And you fall into the, you know, pit of breastplates.
Oh, my God.
Children probably couldn't participate, but, like, yeah, here for it. Mm-hmm. I like it a lot. And, like, Olek has, like, lashes.
Yes.
And lipstick. Oh, my God. And then he teaches you the herstory.
Yes.
And you have to, like, memorize it.
Yes!
Yes! I love it!
I love this. Maybe you have to collect a necklace?
Yeah.
With, like, an amulet?
Well, wasn't definitely that? A tiara or some sort of crown.
Yeah.
For sure.
Yeah.
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 And then, like, are you, like, instead of, like, the purple piranhas, like, you have to be, like, other things?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Kitty girls.
Sure. Uh-huh. I was thinking colors still, alliteration with
Gila,
colors, but, like...
Gila monster?
The Gila. The G sound. It's like Saguaro. Just say talk to.
But I like it.
Yeah, I like this a lot. I'm really here for this show.
I would watch it.
Yeah, so then all of these fabulous queens from previous seasons come out.
Yes. Monique Hart.
Yes.
Like, eyeball dress and this wig with these box braids. And yes, it was so good. And James Mansfield, yes. Who we saw,
yep.
Runs out with her phone. Yep. Loved it. Just yes. Like, hey, bitch.
This little pink number. And
she was using her breastplate as a phone carrier earlier in the night, and I enjoyed that.
Yeah, that was silly. I think actually in our picture, her phone is on her tits.
I liked it a lot.
Yeah.
It was like when women are pregnant and they like eat off their stomachs.
Yes.
You know,
yes.
That similar vibe, and I liked it.
The shelf.
Yeah, the shelf. So many fabulous queens, and everyone's walking down, and it was like, yes, and this person, that person. And then a mystery, I mean, okay.
I feel a little bad, but we did not recognize Venus Delight.
No.
To be fair, I think she was on maybe an episode or two.
She was on an episode of season 3.
Yeah.
Well, and I haven't seen her since.
No.
Like, it's not like, oh, she showed up again, mm-hmm. and remember her. So, yeah, she came out, and I swear to God, I was like, is that Robin Mansions? Is that Sharon's makeover person? Because she's got the
eye patch,
and just like, I don't know, something about the vibe of it all. And I was like, what?
And I was like, wow, what a comeback. Like, good for her. And then I was like, that doesn't make sense. But... Also, she looks like Madonna.
Yeah.
Particularly with this eye patch, whatever. And
right.
That makes sense that it was Venus Delight because
she's like a Madonna impersonator.
Yeah.
But like, I'm serious. We spent a cool 45 minutes trying to figure out who she was because it wasn't on any of the lists.
No, they should have announced it. They should have had Michelle be
Yeah, oh, and
you know, and Venus Delight.
Yeah.
Raja, you know.
Would have been good.
Pandora Box. You know,
yeah.
Why not? And then that's another way to reintroduce them to the new fans that haven't watched season 3.
This fabulous bitch that wore an eye patch and looks like Madonna at the finale. Yeah, it's Venus Delight. Follow.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, get her those Instagram followers.
Yeah. She comes out and then right after, oh my God, the Queen Mother, Raja in this galaxy coat. I mean, somebody said like a queen that doesn't need a reveal and a shablam and a blah, blah, blah to like make a statement because it's so true. She just has the fucking attitude.
Oh, she knows how to walk a runway
of
like
course,
no one else.
But it's like, you don't need that stuff if you sure. own it. You know,
yep.
like you that's if that's not what you what the kind of queen you are,
yep. Yep.
that's fine. But she turned the corner and everyone lost their fucking mind.
Well, also though, she was just like, you know, everyone would come out like most of the way onto the stage.
Oh, hi, here I am. Okay.
And then go off to the side where they're supposed to stand. And Raj is just like, oh, what, bitch? I'm gonna walk all the way down every inch
all
of this fucking runway.
Down. Stop at the end.
Turn.
Pause. Yes.
Eat me up, bitches.
World.
Meanwhile, everyone's going, oh my god! As glasses.
Ah, everyone is losing their minds. She took her time.
Oh my god.
It was so good. And then they cut most of it from the finale.
Yeah, which is a bummer.
And then Angina came out. Yeah. Looking so cute.
Yeah.
Oh my god, I love her.
I love her. She was at Drag Queen Bingo Brunch. Not bingo, just brunch.
Oh, okay.
That I went to for a friend's birthday a month ago or whatever and was so fabulous.
Really?
Because like, drag brunch is tough.
Yeah.
Because, like, this one was indoors, so at least the lighting was better. But not great. And you're just, like, interacting, and people are like, oh, I have my waffles. You know, it's, like, a weird situation.
Yeah, I never really got the allure.
It's not my thing.
Okay, great.
I don't particularly want to be eating while interacting like with drag queens.
Like, dinner theater or something.
Yeah.
It's weird.
It is weird. But she made it work, and I was just like, I mean, she was dancing, and just, love her.
And then Coco Montrese looking maybe the best she's ever looked. I mean, she was like just looking snatched and gorgeous and like the gown and everything. I just thought she looked really, really beautiful.
Yeah. Alexis Mateo, everyone went crazy.
Oh yeah, that was
fun. I didn't like that her sleeves were unlined.
Yeah, I didn't like that either.
But she's fun.
But it was very exciting.
Bam!
Bam!
She didn't do that.
She should have had a fan. Bam! Mm.
That'd be fun.
Vanjie.
You know what I was thinking? I really want a fan that says odd bless.
Hashtag odd bless or just odd bless?
Just odd bless.
Odd bless.
But I want it like designed, like, you know, like have like Rick or someone like make a really fancy cool design.
Should it be like sort of in, you know, like traditional, like religious looking text?
Oh.
Or no?
Maybe?
Or I like the idea that it's just odd bless, but then like the rays of the fan or like rays of the sun and
ooh,
it's like religious in that way.
Odd bless. That could work.
That could be fun.
Yeah. Ideas.
Yeah.
You're welcome, Evie.
All the queens have come out. Everyone's like, yes, work. And then Vanjie comes out, interrupts everything.
Now tonight, before our...
Hold it. Stop the press.
Hold on. Hold the phone. Wait a minute. I want my face up on that wheel, Miss RuPaul. I can still win this thing. You know, it was just like... And, I mean, we stopped the show.
Oh, it was...
Because we were chanting so
hard. I'm not
going
to lie. I personally take a little bit of responsibility.
We definitely started the chant.
We were like... Because I, in my head, was like, you know what?
It could
There's
happen.
1,600 people in this theater.
It could happen.
Or more, whatever.
Yeah.
If we all just won't shut up until they do it, like...
Ru wants to get home. She might as well just bring it up. But they would...
But they weren't prepared.
They would, like, throw off the algorithm.
They weren't prepared for that.
No.
But I was like, then shame on you, producers, right? For not being prepared for that. Because also, like, it would have been better.
Yeah.
Darling, lover, it's a little too late for that. It's late. I mean...
At least we got this fun video.
Oh my gosh, her woman on the street video.
I mean.
Talking to her future husband.
Oh my.
You are fine as hell. Are you single or taken?
I'm taken.
It don't even matter.
What's up, Angie?
The winner of season 11 and your wife, me.
Well, I guess it's interesting now, when they filmed it, when they showed us that at the live taping, we didn't know that Brooklyn and Vanjie had broken up.
No, we didn't.
Did she have a boo? A man?
She's got a few.
Oh, she's one of those.
Yeah.
She's like Brooklyn.
She's like Brooklyn.
Likes to sleep around or whatever. I was like, ooh.
Oh, this tea.
Oh, it's golden. Ooh. Ooh.
This tea is so hot. Oh my gosh.
Vanjie video was really funny,
yeah.
And it just like furthers our point that she should be on television more. And it's just called 555 Vanessa Vanjie
Voting
Voters
dot MeCute.net.
Like, whoa! Oh, so good.
Vanjie, I've made my decision. Congratulations, you are the winner of season 11.
Yeah!
I honestly think that a really large portion of that theater would have been fully happy if she just won and we all went home.
Yeah, because this was like 3 hours in.
Sure, they hadn't even lip-synced yet.
Yeah, so, you know, I was like, well, yeah, sure.
Yeah.
I'm okay with it.
Sounds good.
Next, Evie's video.
Yeah.
I've always been a little bit different, but that's because normal is boring.
Which, I mean, it still wasn't like, amazing, but it was like really way funnier than the rest.
I don't know if it's just that it's my kind of humor or what it was, but it was for me, this was much more entertaining.
It helps that we like her, yes, right? And that she's our favorite. But also, it just seemed like a clearer focus. Like, Evie just like knows who she is, knows how to present herself,
and I think she tells
her story really succinctly.
Yes.
And then her like blue spiked dumpster spiky monster,
then blending into the blue wall.
And then like the free hug.
Oh my god!
Free hugs. Anyway.
And everyone's like, yeah, walk away. She's talking about, oh, I gotta like be zen and calm down and not, you know, come for queens and all of these things. And her and Love Connie are like meditating. Well, I will say this, so like we kind of gave Love Connie some shit. In the mini challenge. It wasn't so much Love Connie, it was the editing and sort of the lack of structure.
Absolutely.
of a mini challenge that I complained about. But I'll say this, she was a fucking professional. She was basically the hype man for 6 hours and was like, had so much energy, was dancing around like in between all the commercial breaks, was like showing her ass, keeping everyone like dancing and just like pumping it up, making jokes. I was like really impressed with her.
I agree.
So then Evie comes out, and I mean, they cut this down too, but like Evie got the full standing ovation chanting, Evie, Evie, clapping, oh my god, like again.
For a very long time. I think this was actually the longest, because then she got emotional.
She was like, couldn't believe how like excited everyone was for her, and how like much they were cheering for her, and she was, you know, doing that face that Evie does where you can tell that she's like about to cry, you know, you just know when it like the lip drops and you're like, oh yeah. And was really taken aback by just how much positivity was coming her way. And it was lovely, and they trimmed it down.
Yeah, I guess they wanted
to. So it wasn't so obvious.
Yeah, they wanted to make it seem more fair.
I mean, she got multiple standing ovations and chants that they had to then stop what they were doing to pause for us to calm down throughout the night. So it was like pretty evident she was winning. That's all I would say.
But she comes out in this
body
exhibit
dress. Oh my god. I mean, yes, we've seen this thing kind of done before, but this was just so perfectly done. It was like all the muscles like were glittering. I mean, Mondo from Project Runway did this. I mean, it was like such a fun way for her to show vulnerability by being like, and I'm showing you all of my insides. You know what I mean? It's just like the way she thinks is just so, so smart. And then this sort of like, I don't even know. This headpiece was just so fascinating to look at, and the makeup, and just like, oh my god. And she had a body tag on her ankle that was like she was in the morgue. Oh, I loved it.
It's good. It's great.
I think this was my favorite look of the night.
Wow. Mine was her final lip sync.
See, like, I loved what that outfit did, but this, to me, was just more perfection.
Okay.
Fucking loved it. Yeah, her headdress was like all the torn muscles or something.
Sure,
you know,
yeah, just like sort of tendons and whatever.
Oh, it's so good.
It's got like beef jerky, I don't know.
Yeah, we're going to do an exhibit. Okay, now that like Miss Frizzle was going to come out and go,
yes,
this is your body.
Yeah, I mean, it was like that museum exhibit, bodies.
Yeah.
But yes.
100%.
Also Miss Frizzle.
Also Miss Frizzle.
Maybe the headpiece was the Miss Frizzle part. I'm not sure.
I mean, always Miss Frizzle?
Always.
So... And she comes out and is, you know, talking, and her parents are both there, and they haven't
been
in the same room for 10 years, haven't talked for 5 years. She's like taken aback by that, emotional by that too. We couldn't see.
No, yeah, we couldn't see that.
But then the internet exploded and decided, I mean, it's true, but decided that Evie's dad was a, you know, zaddy.
Zaddy. Zaddy Oddly.
Everyone lost their mind.
Yeah.
Papa Oddly, I hear you play Evie and Brooklyn's lip sync for your motorcycle club. That sounds really hot.
That sounds hot. And he was so like,
I made them watch for
it
too.
I don't want to feel about this. RuPaul's hitting on me. And then, you know, as Evie was walking up, yet another chanting for Evie. It was just. Knowing now, like having, we don't have to worry about it now. It was very evident in the room.
Yeah.
where it was going.
Yep. So another quick commercial break. Potentially, we've been struggling with YouTube flagging our videos for not suitable for all advertisers, and we don't know why, and it seems to be gay related, but we don't really know, and they won't tell us. So you might get an ad, or you might not, but it just means that our Patreon supporters mean more than ever to us. So really, thank you. Also, here's an ad. Or not. The top four come out ready to lip sync for their motherfucking lives. Well, for the crown, excuse me.
Lip sync?
For the crown.
I mean, it was exciting when they wheeled the wheel out.
Was it?
Well, I was like, oh, there it is, look.
Sure.
Exciting?
I guess I was not excited, but I'm glad you were.
We were on that side.
Yes, it was right near us.
I mean, they just spin it, and it took forever.
Oh, my God. It's still spilling for a while.
Still spilling?
Shut up. I hope you'll just slide by it.
Well, we didn't talk about their looks.
Oh, no.
I mean, it was just like seeing them all four in a row, it was just like more evident who came to fucking win.
Yeah.
Just based on the looks, right? Like, Akira looked beautiful.
Yeah.
But somehow it just wasn't as, like, grand.
No, it was
and
like,
Silky's
this is a fun
too.
Dance
like,
outfit.
Just wasn't as grand.
It was like, this is a fun pink dance outfit, sure.
Exactly. So, like, Akira, I mean, she kind of looked like the magician's assistant or something.
A little bit.
Like, a little bit of a collar and this, like, you know, blue fringe. Obviously, we know why now, but, like, the wig seemed just sort of, like, nice.
Right.
You know, it wasn't, I mean, it was. I mean, she should have worn, like, the wig. Like, the wig. That got more screen time than Soju.
Oh, the wig, yeah, of course.
The wig.
Yeah.
You know, that would have been
silly
and fun. But, you know, she looked beautiful. I like this color on her. Brooklyn in this Annie Lennox striptease dominatrix. Like, yes! Oh, my God. Black and red is becoming her color story. Yes. And just,
I mean, we, well, I was, I like that I was pointing, like, it, our logo was on my chest. When
it
actually,
usually
in fact,
is.
Brooklyn is.
Brooklyn is. I mean, but she just, I mean, this was, like, so good.
Yeah.
And then Silky, and just, like, a, like, you know, she looked pretty, but just, like, a kind of plain, like, pink dress.
Yeah.
With this huge afro, which is, like, fun in that it's, like, the size of...
Mars.
And then, I mean, can we talk about this Evie look? Maybe this was my favorite Evie look.
I was surprised that you didn't say this
one. I fucking loved them all. Maybe this wasn't this. I mean, I loved this so much.
This is really fun, particularly when you know all of the things that literally went into it and the thought process that went into it.
Oh my God. I mean, this like Nickelodeon 90s, you know, Avaryl Monsters, Rugrats, Wild Thornberries, just like barf onto her. I mean, I fucking loved this.
But then, of course, she's talked now since about how it also included a piece of every outfit that she wore on the runway during the show.
So cool.
And like all of these different aspects and elements of the journey, and it was inspired by fan art, and it's just like this whole cool...
It was just such an idea.
Yes.
Like you can just tell when there's so much thought put into something and behind it, and the shoot, the huge yellow boots.
Platform
boots. You
know,
it looks like she's going to rave.
Yeah, these like
and
moon boots.
Like pink dreadlocks and just like... I mean, when we were there in person, I couldn't stop staring. I was like, oh, and what's that? And there's like a Mickey Mouse hand with like some pink nail polish on. And what's that? And there's a mouth over there. And one of her hands has like
octopus
tendrils. And one of them has like that like toddler game with the rings that you have to get them on the right size. It's like a rainbow or whatever. And I was just like,
yeah.
Oh, my God. Fucking loved it.
I love this look.
They spin the wheel,
yes, it
and
lands
it's nerve-wracking. You know, it lands on Silky.
I don't like this choice format of this lip sync off because it gives this person so much power that no one else gets just because the wheel landed on them. It's weird.
Well, I mean, it really makes no sense to me that then the next person gets to choose a random box.
Right.
Like, they should literally get
to
pick which song. They should be like, do you want Bootylicious or do you want SOS? And then go, I want that one.
Yeah. Yeah, she got to pick me, so now I get to pick my song. Maybe it's just we spin the wheel and we randomly match you guys up.
There you go. There you go.
You know, first Silky. And next is Evie. Oh my God. You know, like finally they get to lip sync against each other. Like she's been threatening the entire season and we didn't get to see because...
This, so she took... I mean,
oh my God.
Lands on Silky. Who's she going to pick? And she stood there for, I mean, it felt like 5 minutes.
It felt like forever.
It wasn't that long, but like, just stood there and we're going, okay, she's gonna pick Evie, like,
let's get on with it.
It only makes sense.
Get on with it!
Just pick Evie already. Like, obviously, this is, like, how it's supposed to happen or whatever.
And then she just goes...
That weird... And Brooklyn is totally like...
Everyone was just like, what's happening?
Girl, what? After all this. After right, exactly. all the talk about
exactly.
sending her
send
home.
Send you home, yeah.
Ugh. I was just like, really? After all this?
But now she could have picked Akira, thereby ensuring that she went to the second, or not ensuring that she
like,
went to the second.
Ensuring but, that either Brooke or Evie wouldn't be in.
Exactly.
Because they were the top. So make those bitches lip sync against each other.
Yeah.
And knock one of them out, because I don't want to knock one of those bitches
exactly.
out.
Exactly. But I'm glad she didn't.
Well, sure.
It made for better TV sure. that she did it the way she did.
Maybe they told her to do that. I don't know.
Do
you want to pick box number one or box 96?
And it's bootylicious.
The crowd erupted.
Oh my God. Everyone was so freaking excited. I mean, as they should have been.
Yes. And then, I mean, this is our shining moment.
Oh my God.
I suppose. Rue.
Two queens stand behind me. That always makes me laugh.
No, this is us genuinely laughing at Rue and this
it
joke.
Was.
Because I remember laughing really hard at this joke.
I did. The way that Rue presented it was just... There was something about it.
It came out of nowhere.
There was, exactly.
It was, seemed off the cuff.
And we were just like, what?
And we were just like, yes!
That always makes me laugh.
And now we have this gift forever.
Oh my God.
The gift that keeps giving.
Oh yeah. So the lip sync starts.
Yes.
Silky reveals her wig. I mean, she just tears her wig off immediately and her...
Well, yeah, she just kind of pulls off her dress and again, turns her back to the audience and just sort of flops...
Yep.
The wig off, like she's done in the past. I'm like, why are you turning your back to the audience? I don't know, it just seemed like a weird choice.
It is.
To turn around.
And do it forward over your head.
Yeah, I don't know. There was no like moment in the song or
exactly.
moment built.
It was just like, oh, I don't think you're ready. Okay.
It's time for a reveal already.
It yeah. Like,
ah!
I mean, it's not. She's not the only person to do this, but I...
No, no.
Yeah, it drives me crazy.
Yeah, I don't... You really have to make it a
if
moment.
You're going to do a reveal, make it a thing.
Yeah.
Otherwise, I don't care.
Brooklyn... pulling on her chains that are attached to the top of her boots to reveal her red toe shoes that then she kicks the bottom half of the boots off and then she's on point doing the lipstick. I was like, yes! That's a great reveal. Like, yes, we've already seen her on toe shoes
yes.
on point. You know, had she just come out there already on point, not as fun.
You're right.
Oh, bitch, she's in these thigh-high boots. How's she going to get into toe shoes? What? What?
And I mean, yeah, like a shoe reveal, never been done.
Never been done. Loved it.
Yeah. And then, I mean, I asked if she could twerk on point.
She
didn't quite give it to us, but almost.
Pretty close.
Pretty close.
Very close.
Yeah.
I wish she had. But yes,
then
her like
bootylicious, like
handstand up.
Oh my God.
You know, dancing on, I mean, it was just
lip
so
syncing
good.
Upside down, just like blah, blah, blah. It
because
was
the way that where we were sitting, it was hard. If anyone did the splits or was like on the ground, we couldn't really see them. And so seeing like Brooklyn just appear upside down against this pillar and then start dancing, it was like, oh my God, yes!
It was stunning. That was the best part about being at the finale was that we got to see the lip syncs like live. Except there were moments like you said, like when they were down on the floor,
right.
Which happened a fair amount because they both would go down and then Silky rolled around on the floor
you
for a little
kinda,
bit.
You could kind of like hear people cheering that were in seats where they could
where
see.
Where they could see.
The interesting part is that like, so then they'll cut to Rue's reaction going, oh, or whatever. And the funny part is they filmed those after the fact.
Yeah.
And they play the songs, and this time it was just Eureka and Kennedy, not half doing a lip sync, but like, you know, doing like a fun performance,
yes.
Not like a full out lip sync for your mother.
Kennedy was in flats.
She was in like shower slippers. So they did a whole performance, and that's when they lit Rue.
Yes, they brought in this whole lighting
then
rig.
Be like, oh, so that was interesting.
It was. I don't think that's the case for the regular lip sync.
No, because they're already
because they already have a lighting set up and whatever.
Yeah, yeah.
But because of the way the stage was, they couldn't have the lights on the stage
right.
for Rue while they were lip syncing.
Rue did watch the lip sync.
Yes, and reacted, but like
her react. Yeah, exactly.
Get the close up.
So that was kind of fun.
Yeah.
But Eureka and Kennedy were fun.
They were super fun.
Yeah.
It was a good, they both had really good lip syncs.
And then Silky tears away another dress
yes.
to reveal. I mean, it's just that they all were sort of the same material, just in different colors.
Yes, it reminded me of like a chameleon.
Yeah.
Maybe it's from The Incredibles. They're being hit and they keep changing colors.
Oh.
And then like different patterns, oh. It's like polka dots and
right. I like have a vague idea of what you're talking about,
yeah.
But I can imagine it.
But that's what it made. It's like, oh, now pick. Now I'm right. Now I'm right.
Yeah. Yeah. This one.
But it's like the same thing.
Yeah. But I did enjoy when Silky tore her wig down the middle.
Oh,
that
God.
Was fun.
Yeah. It's like, I don't think
she's
I've ever
like,
seen that.
Yeah. Pulled it apart. Unfortunately, she tore the wig down the middle to reveal like a pretty out of the bag, shake and go blue wig. And
really
I was like,
bad.
Oh, less fun.
Yeah, I mean, I said when we watched it, this is not even like a Party City wig, this is like a dollar store wig that Evie bought in her new music video.
Oh,
dollar store.
I see what you did there. But I did enjoy.
Yeah, I mean, that was
the tear down the middle.
Yeah.
I mean, Brooklyn's got the lip sync down and she's dancing and she's twirling and she's doing the splits and she's doing all of these things and then Silky was sort of rolling around. I just don't know if we can call this choreography. Rolling around. I don't know what she was doing.
Yeah, I don't know. It was a lot of rolling.
Yeah.
It's like we can be heroes when she's going to roll all the way to Uluru.
But when you are rolling and the juices in your brain are spinning around, it does feel very, very fast.
To Uluru.
I'm losing it. I didn't really have it, and I fully
lost it. No, it's, you know, it was like when you're a kid and you like roll down a grassy knoll and
yes.
You're just like tuck and roll.
Yeah.
It just felt like that. Brooklyn wins.
Yes.
Brooklyn Heights, Shantae, you stay.
So another commercial break, and we'll be back with more lip syncs.
Now I just imagine like a sink. You know?
Lip syncs
and then
filled with lips.
And then like the lips are the drain.
Oh.
And they're singing.
Oh, they're singing.
Lip sync.
Sure. Well, but it could just be a lip sync.
No, but it's a lip sync.
Okay. Over your face, but
yeah.
The only thing that comes out is
yeah.
Your lips in the drain. And there's a sink around your face.
Yes. It's like a headdress. It's like a farm sink, you know, get a nice square one that's hard to clean. And then your lips, yes, your lips are the drain. Yes.
Maybe you're painted like the same,
you're just,
to blend
you're
in with the sink.
Blended in and then like, you know, oh man, I like that. That'd be silly and fun.
It'd be weird.
It'd be weird.
Yeah.
So then out comes Akuria and Evie and they have the leftover case.
Yes.
And
they get to pick nothing.
Yeah, they get nothing. There's no advantage to going second either, really.
No.
They need to reevaluate the rules.
A little bit.
A little bit. Just tweak them a little bit.
Yeah.
But anyway, they get the leftover case and
it says SOS.
SOS. I got so excited. I was like, oh my God, it's going to be ABBA. I can't wait.
Someone's going to have a red scarf. No. No, it was Rihanna.
I got really excited that it was going to be ABBA. I thought that would have been a real fun lip sync.
I think it would be a fun lip sync. I would like to see that in the future.
Have we had an ABBA lip sync?
I don't think so.
I think that'd be so fun.
That'd be so fun. There's so many that you can choose from.
Right?
Oh, a million.
Fernando, that would be a fun one.
Oh my God, that would be a fun one.
It would be like so melodramatic.
Oh yes.
I love that.
Hear me call Fernando.
Fernando. It'd be good.
But maybe shares Fernando?
Yeah, of course. Can you hear the drums, Fernando?
I'm not gonna lie.
The whole Cher album?
Sure.
Oh my God, if it had been a night of Cher singing ABBA lip sync for your life.
Yes.
I think they should do more themes.
I do like the theme.
Yeah.
I mean, this was kind of a theme in terms of like
poppy,
yeah. But not like, it wasn't like, oh, Whitney night. But yes.
Oh my gosh.
SOS,
so it's
Rihanna.
It's not ABBA.
No.
Evie's, you know, octopus.
I mean, it reminds me of Sharon Needles, of course.
I love it. I just love it. The way her face is just like so, I mean, I just loved it.
This song has a lot of different voice tracks that you can pick.
Uh-huh.
And it's always interesting to me who picks what.
Uh-huh.
I liked what Evie chose, where it was like, oh, that's not necessarily what you would think people would pick,
mm-hmm.
but it made it more fun,
mm-hmm.
made it more interesting, a little weirder. You know,
well,
it's like,
of course.
Exactly. It's
she
like,
has an octopus hand.
Yeah,
I mean, so
yeah.
She was getting really weird with it, with her hands and her eyes, and it was just like so much fun.
Yeah.
And then her free Britney underwear.
Oh my gosh, which we couldn't really read at the time.
You couldn't read it great on the edit.
That's true.
It wasn't like...
It was so fast and whatever.
It wasn't quite the moment I think she had wanted it to be.
Yes.
But there was other moments.
I will say this, though. Okay, so I kind of lied the other night in our live video. I didn't quite go to bed immediately. I did go catch a viewing party.
Rude.
At a bar in WeHo. You went to bed because you were more sick than I was.
I did go to bed. I went and watched some episodes of Lucifer.
Oh.
Which is just a terrible show that I'm really enjoying. It's very stupid. But I'm thoroughly enjoying falling asleep to it. So.
Is it kind of like how I was with Drop Dead Diva? Where it's just like really stupid but kind of fun?
Yes, it's that.
Great.
Where you're just like, what is this? Like, what in the hell is even going on? Like, the logic that he's the devil and he just tells everyone? And they're all like, well, you're clearly a head case, but we're gonna keep letting you work on police cases.
What the hell is wrong with you?
Why are you so surprised, detective? I'm the devil, remember? I'm evil.
Good.
What's happening? Good. What's going on here?
Good.
So anyway,
yeah,
Lucifer.
Anyway, yeah, funny. So no, but so I went to a bar in WeHo for a viewing of these, and it was fun because the Free Britney did play.
Oh, good, okay.
In the bar, there were a lot of people that were like, woo! Especially because now, like when it aired, I feel like it was more of a, Britney, her situation.
Sure, has only increased.
Worsened?
I mean, like in... public
yeah
eye.
It's become crazier, yeah. So you know, I think it was more relevant,
but both of their lip syncs are fucking on point.
Yeah,
Evie's giving it a little more flavor.
Yes,
like Akira's do is great, but like Evie was giving me a little more personality with it. And then she goes into like Warrior 2, you know, like she like pulls her leg out from behind her and is doing like some yoga pose. I was like, yeah, what's going on with this, with these huge fucking yellow Big Bird boots? And I was like, yes. Yes, yes, yes.
But then meanwhile...
Oh my god! Akira flips down and does the splits, flips off her wig to reveal this like fabulous fringed shower cap.
Yeah.
She's Diane Carroll again.
Oh my god.
And then flips back to like do the aerial splits, and I was just like, yes!
Meanwhile, Evie's gone from like Warrior 2 into like jump splits down, they're both on the ground.
Slam this, blah! Yeah. Oh, it was so good.
It's really good.
It's culminating to the end, and oh my god, blah, blah, blah. And then Evie's like bridge backbend, yes. Like in this outfit with the smiles and the eyeballs and the faces and her face being like, yeah. And I was just like, ah, I love all of this. Oh yeah. My god.
It's good.
So yeah, I mean, Evie won.
Yeah.
I also think fairly, you know.
I think so.
I was like, yeah. I mean, Akira was very good, but I was like, Evie clearly won. If one of her arms had been the black and white snake monster from Beetlejuice,
yeah, that'd be good.
I would have liked that. But yeah, no, Evie, I mean, I just love her.
Yeah.
I just think she's fabulous.
Yeah.
I'm so happy how the whole night turned out.
Absolutely.
Just really excited about it.
Because the next is Miss Congeniality, and Monet Exchange is back. Again, I was like, this is insane that this has been a year, but okay, great.
It's a year in her life. It's been a whirlwind.
Yeah.
No, I mean, I like this for Monet. I thought it was very simple and elegant. I think the chest was reading very boy,
yeah.
And could have used a little shading. Just something, or maybe it's even bigger of a drop, or something, but like the chest was just reading big boy.
Yeah.
But I really liked this just simple high slit. You know, she looked like Ariel at the end with that purple shining dress when she like walks out of the water, except it was yellow. She's gonna pass the torch.
Yes. So this was interesting. So.
Oh, right.
In filming, they had this whole spiel for her that she did not do a very good job at reading the prompter of.
No, she messed it up a number of times. And at this point, we had been there for 5.5 hours.
Yeah. We're like, let's get this show on.
You could tell Rue was like, girl.
Yep. You got it. I mean, I think she was like, she done fucked it up or something. It was like,
yeah.
She called her out.
Yeah.
But they had this whole thing about like, oh, well, Rue, you know, you can't trust anything on the internet and internet voting and... dating and they
Grindr,
say this is 10 inches. I don't know.
There was a whole spiel about because the cast members voted.
Yes.
But they couldn't get a good take out of it. And so that they just
scrapped it. They didn't mention it at all.
Moving on.
And it was just like, you know, cool. The winner is
the teeth whitening by Crest.
Yeah,
and
exactly.
Then it was like, and moving on.
Yep.
Maybe if Monet had had like a little like golden headband or some kind of like some headpiece in some way, I would have liked that.
You know what would have been really fun?
A feather. Oh. Like a something.
Oh, yeah. Sure.
What?
I was thinking more just like camp drag, and then like Monet wouldn't have done this, I don't think, but if someone came as like a toothbrush. Or real deep cut.
How would you do that?
Like, I don't know. You could. You
like, what would the bristles be?
Bristle? Like a.
But like, would it be coming out of this way? Or maybe. Coming out of this way?
No.
Like a mohawk of
maybe,
bristles?
Maybe, yeah, maybe like a mohawk of bristles.
Are you
like
an electric toothbrush?
Maybe, like an Oral-B.
You know?
Yeah, that floss action. I don't know.
Yeah.
But I think that'd be kind of fun.
Sure.
And, or, yeah. Real deep cut, someone went as Jan from Grease, doing the brush and brush and brush them. Just really lean into the silliness of like, oh,
their,
Crest is here.
They're real, you know, like dry, ratted pigtails. And a Twinkie and a bottle of wine.
It's a dessert wine. Fashion, fashion.
Yeah, Monet was very like, lady sings the blues. Let me go, give me the microphone. Maybe if she had a big, you know, white flower in her hair or something. Ooh. Then it would have been like real Billie Holiday.
Well, yeah.
I'm here for a real Billie Holiday look because I love it.
Yeah.
Need a win.
Yes, just like we wanted and everyone in the entire world.
That was like a no-brainer. Yeah. Need a win! I mean, the crowd erupted. Everyone was like losing their mind.
Nina. And I love that Nina's really taken the torch and
yes.
run with it.
She's just like a really good ambassador.
She exactly.
And she's very like political and yep. smart and like yep. knows how to.
She's see. A great face and a good eloquent speaker.
Love it.
And so it's like, yeah. yes, bitch, love it.
Is there anything you'd like to say?
Meh.
Yeah. People just lost their fucking mind. This was so funny.
Yeah.
And then she gives like a nice actual speech.
Yes.
Because she's fabulous.
Yes.
But this was like cleared the air for the yeah. black spot on her performance
well, and
of the season.
The black the leper
orange,
spot.
The orange spot.
Was they orange?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Was they orange? Yeah. They were.
Shut up. Leaves me alone.
Leaves me alone. I want to be alone.
I just want to be alone.
So another quick commercial break and we'll be right back.
What was that?
I don't know. It's just exciting.
Back. And then, oh my god.
Oh my god.
Oh my god. Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
I mean, by far my favorite look of the night, I have to be honest.
I mean, so the curtains come, or the doors open. She,
whatever.
She is revealed.
Yes.
Right.
Oh my god. Aquaria.
Our reigning queen Aquaria comes out. Holy shit, this was amazing. Still mad she didn't wear this to the Met Gala.
Yes.
Still mad. I don't think I'm gonna ever get over it.
No.
How
so,
fucking great would this have been? It would have been so much more talked about too.
Oh my god.
It seemed like her look was just like she wanted to fade away.
Yeah. It's like this is camp at the Met Gala. You gotta be loud.
Oh,
this
my
would
God.
Have been perfect.
So fucking good. So fucking good. But anyway, oh my God, this, you know, Nina Flowers by way of RuView, just like fantasy with this mohawk. I mean, oh, we should have started a chant. RuView! 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 That would have been so good.
Maybe rude, but.
But like, it was like fashion RuView.
It was. Nina Flowers does RuView.
Oh,
also with like some carnival, like.
Yeah, Phoenix.
Yeah, oh. You know. Yeah.
These, and the shoes, these like heelless talon bird, I don't even know, and the feathers, I mean, her and her feathers being like mic'd, like every time she moved, I was like, just gonna fly away.
Yes. I have had the pleasure to fly all around.
Well, I've been able to fly all over the world. I love her. She's silly.
She's really fun. But yeah. This was...
Her face looked so fucking flawless.
Her feathered... She seemed to have a feathered vagine.
I don't think it was feathers. It was rhinestones that were closer. They were all, like, tighter. And I think it was airbrushing.
It was, like, shadows from certain angles.
I think it was the airbrushing the piece of the fabric.
But anyway, I mean, I was excited that she, you know, made it anatomically correct.
Sure. She's a natural woman bird. She's a natural birdman. Bird woman.
Bird woman.
Yeah.
Bird lady.
Yeah. Lady bird.
Feed the birds. Toppings the birds. That would have been fun.
Sure.
It was really breathtaking.
A+.
Truly breathtaking.
Yeah. I mean, we were gagged.
Yeah, and so was the crowd. Yeah,
and the, we weren't the only ones in the crowd gagged. Like, everyone was fucking gagged.
Why y'all gagging so? She bring it to you every ball.
But yes, we get to the final lip sync. Well, and this is when, so like, the way it was set up, but there was one big door, you know, the yes. big doors in the middle, and then there was like these two wings on the side.
Yeah.
And where we were sitting, we could see where Evie was getting ready to come out.
And at first I was like, I don't want to look, I don't want to see the outfit,
like,
I don't want
to
see.
Oh no, I don't want
to
see.
But then I was like, I can't stop looking at it.
Well, and the whole time, whenever it was a commercial break or they weren't filming, they were playing like Rue tracks yeah. on loop.
Oh my God, on loop. It was like the albums just kept, oh my God.
But they were playing Peanut Butter.
Peanut Butter,
which is one of my favorites. And I love that Evie he's like in this, you know, brown, like peanut butter colored, you know, I was like into it. In the wings, just going.
Yeah, she's just like lip syncing and dancing. And I like love that because it's just like the whole night she was having fun mm-hmm. and you could tell. And when she wasn't performing for anyone, she was having fun.
Exactly. She was just happy to like be experiencing this.
Yeah.
It was, you could tell, you could just like feel, it was so good. They come out and they're gonna lip sync yes. to Edge of Glory.
By Lady Gaga.
Lady Gaga. Radio Gaga. All we hear is Radio Gaga. You know that's where she got her name?
No.
The Queen song?
Really?
Radio Gaga?
Wow.
That's what I've always been told.
Oh, cool. Yeah. I didn't know that.
Oh, yeah.
Love it.
But yes, they come out and Brooklyn in this reveal cloak.
Oh my God, yeah, which is really silly.
It really made me laugh. Yeah. I liked it a lot.
Yeah, particularly because it's such a thing now.
Like, yeah.
Thanks, Sasha Lore. You were amazing, but yeah. also you set us up for a lot of failures.
I appreciate you. You set the bar too high. It's too high. Yeah, so Brooklyn's in this just cloak. Reveal. And Evie in this brown. I mean, I don't love a brown gown. I'll be honest.
A brown gown?
A brown gown is not my favorite.
No, sure.
It's not my favorite. But this whole look, this lotus mirrored headpiece.
Oh my God, this headpiece.
And the sort of like eyelet, the gold like eyelets on the top up here.
Yeah,
and then like it goes down and it's brown. I mean, it's just like head to toe. It's just like, oh, okay, this is a lurk.
Yeah.
I mean, it's just so fucking smart. She's got her face and then her lip sync is reflected on the two other blinders.
And it read
the mirror,
so well on TV.
So well on camera. It's really smart.
Yeah.
Really, oh, really smart.
You want me to lip sync? Here.
A visual eye.
Three lip syncs. Yeah, she does. A visual eye.
She's a triple fucking threat. So they have to lip sync to Edge of Glory. And, you know, they're both really on point. Yeah. Oh, Evie's bleeding eyes. We didn't talk about her bleeding eyes. That was so good. And they both, you know, were building to something. Evie was really giving me all the emotions right here. And Brooklyn turning around and then the back of the cloak says, here comes the reveal. I was just like, yes! Oh, it was so good. And then this like spin out of the cloak into this like mirrored jumpsuit thing that would like yes. look really expensive and beautiful.
Yes, yes.
It's like silver and gold situation. Didn't love the wig.
I didn't love the gold on the dress, and I think that's what clashed with the wig.
Yeah.
I wish the gold was more of like a maybe like a rosé, like a rose, like ooh, a sparkling rosé color.
Sure.
You know, that kind of like pinkish, like millennial pink. Or a light gold, like a champagne color.
But this reveal was fabulous.
It was. Well, this is where like the tempo kind of picks up.
Brooklyn's dancing and twirling and splitting and doing, and like doing really, really well, but sort of doing what we've seen from her.
That was my feeling, and also kind of almost doing too much.
A little bit.
It was a little extra.
A little more dancing than lip syncing.
Sure.
A little bit. You know, it wasn't integrated as well as in other lip syncs that she's done. And Evie, who, you know, easily could be backflipping and handstanding and doing all of these crazy things that we've seen, it's all right here.
Yep.
In the triple face.
Yep.
And you're like, oh my God, bitch, this is so good. What's happening? She was so smart to like find a way to keep this secret for as long as she did into the song.
Yeah.
But as soon as she turned around and there was that other face, oh my God. Oh my God, everyone lost their minds.
And when I was at the bar, erupted. And I mean, I already knew that she won, but I was like, oh, she won.
You're like, oh good. Oh good, yeah. She did it.
It was a reveal of sorts, but it was just, it was minimalism.
A higher level concept. And blam! What? And then the spinning face.
Oh my God.
My face. Now this face. Now my face. Now this face. Ah!
And there's already three faces. It's just like, ooh, this face. She bends back with the second face.
With the second face and
flips over.
Yes. I mean, in this hoop skirt, I was like,
yeah.
It did seem like that skirt was gonna be a tearaway.
It seemed like that was the bottom reveal.
Somehow, like how it was connected, I was like, I wouldn't have been surprised. Mm-hmm. But then I was like glad it wasn't.
Me too.
It's like you didn't need it.
No. And that's what I really liked about it. It
showed restraint.
It was a study in two approaches to lip syncing. Mm-hmm. And I thought they both were successful.
Very successful and talented.
Like you said, for me, my big thing was I'd seen Brooklyn do this literally 10 minutes prior.
Right.
We haven't seen Evie give this kind of performance, and so it was like an extra level of depth in her
and yet it
capabilities.
Was still Evie.
It was.
She just always managed to
and it was
Evie.
Still surprising.
Yeah.
And it was a performance.
Oh boy.
So I was like, I mean, yes.
I was here for it.
Some people were complaining that she didn't do enough. That she was too low energy. I'm like, but that was the point.
That was the point.
And she gave me everything with her face.
Oh my god, it was all right here.
Faces, excuse me.
All four of them. I really am very, very happy that Evie won, and I really do think she did win.
Yes.
But, like, I wouldn't have been mad.
It was still very close.
It was close.
It was close when we watched it, and I was like, you know, it'll be interesting to see how Rue feels and how, you know, which way it's going to go. I know a lot of people were pissed because Brooklyn technically won more challenges.
Who cares?
I've never cared about that. And someone else pointed out, well, if that's the case, then why have a finale at all? Just crown the person that's had the most wins.
Sure. Sure.
Like, if we're just doing that, so, like, that's stupid to me.
Yeah.
But I would have been happy either way.
Yeah.
But I was happy. I mean, we were Team Evie.
Oh, my gosh. Yes. Evie wins. So exciting. It was interesting that they had to redo her, like, do you want to say anything? Oh. The first take, she goes, you know, oh, keep it on and whatever and blah, blah, blah. And does anyone have a baby I can eat? And everyone was like, yes! Ah! Oh, my God. And then in the room, they were like, oh, we had a sound issue with Evie. We'll have to redo it. And it was clearly like, well, she just said eat a baby on, like, as her winning speech. We can't have this. Okay, we need a backup plan. Sound issue. Okay, let's take it back. One more time. Take it back again.
Follow your oddities and fly your freak flag.
Let your freak flag fly.
Yeah.
And it was like, that was still fun. But she definitely said, does anyone have a baby that I can eat? Just pull a baby out from under her hoop skirt.
Oh my god!
And it still has an umbilical cord. Rude. Love it. Rude. People would be upset. I would love it. Throw it into the audience. Love it! So rude. People would be very upset. I would love it. You know, they filmed Brooklyn winning.
Yes.
And I just kind of remember her, like, holding up the scepter and being like, yes! And, like, the queen of the... I don't know what she said.
She said
something that was not particularly memorable.
No.
Was it during Brooklyn's win that Raja's wig got caught on her... Remember Raja's wig got caught... Was it on her mirror thing? Or was that... Raja's wig got caught on somebody. And it was like, oh, bitch! Oh,
well, I remember noticing when they filmed Evie's win.
Yeah.
That she was, like, very careful with all of the queens because, like, the mirror edges were...
Okay.
I mean, they were covered in something, but they were still pointy.
They were, like, you know, and sharp.
Mirrors.
You know. Ah!
Yeah, yeah. So it was like, hug. It was really funny to watch.
But, like, Raja's hair definitely got caught on
plastique.
She hugged a queen, and it was, like, a problem that she was then like, oh, no. And, like, I was like, oh, how are they going to... I can't use this footage. But that definitely happened. I remember that now. And then... You know, Evie wins and tried to be as energetic as we could.
Yes.
And we were just like, oh my god, yes! So that was fun.
I was kind of bummed because there was footage of me. They came up the aisle because they filmed a few different ones.
Yeah.
And there was definitely one where I was like, yes, Evie!
Oh yeah, I remember that.
They didn't use it. Choices. They used us enough.
We got plenty of screen time. It was fun. It was really fun. So
congratulations to Evie Oddly.
Yes!
God bless.
I'm just, like, really excited that it all came together.
Yeah.
And that we picked her from the beginning.
Yeah.
We really do love her. She's amazing.
She's amazing. Yeah. And so sweet. I mean, we got to meet and Kiki for a minute at her booth
at
DragCon.
Oh, yes. That was so amazing and fun.
Yeah. So hopefully, I mean, she'll be very busy now. But, you know, hopefully we can figure out something in the future.
Oh, that'd be fun.
Yeah.
Thank you for joining us on
this season.
I can't believe we've made it.
I
thought I was going to lose my mind. I mean, I kind of have. But I thought I was really going to lose my mind at this point. It's been a long season, but it's been really fun.
It has been.
So many fabulous queens.
Yes.
And we've been having just a blast doing it. And like, thank you guys for watching.
Yes.
And
subscribe, share whole. Tell everyone to subscribe whole. And make sure to follow us on Instagram.
Yeah.
Follow our Insta stories. Avaryl does a really fun, silly job. There's lots of like little videos of Dharma, you know, trying to play with her reflection.
Yeah, if you like puppies and outfits, I got you covered. Follow us on Twitter.
Yep.
And thumbs up and all of the above. And just like, thanks for joining us.
Yeah.
And cheers to this season.
Cheers.
Evie Oddly.
Yeah.